So, hello everyone. At this class, I'm going to discuss the method to find the intervals in which the given function is increasing or decreasing. अब तक increasing और decreasing function के बारे में क्या क्या discuss किया? The graph of increasing and decreasing functions, as well as how to check whether the function is increasing or strictly increasing. Or decreasing or strictly decreasing. Yes, even I have discussed first derivative test also. Yes, in the last class. Now today I am going to discuss method to find the intervals in which the given function is increasing or decreasing. इसका मतलब है कि जब एक function दिया रहेगा वो function कौन सा interval में increase हो रहा है and कौन सा interval में decrease हो रहा है वो interval कैसे find out करते हैं. लास्ट क्लास में जितना तक डिस्कस किया उसमें इंटरवल दिया था अलोंग विथ द फंक्शन एंड यू हैव टू जस्ट शो दैट द फंक्शन इज इंक्रीजिंग ऑन दिस इंटरवल द फंक्शन इज इंक्रीजिंग डिक्रीजिंग इन दिस इंटरवल. यस, नाउ टुडे यू हैव टू फाइंड द इंटरवल इन व्हिच द फंक्शन इज इंक्रीजिंग और डिक्रीजिंग. सो फॉर दिस सम स्टेप्स आर देयर, सो यू हैव टू फॉलो दीज स्टेप्स. ओके, suppose a function is given to us and you need to find the intervals whether the function is increasing or decreasing, then the following steps are: step 1, at first you have to write the given function f of x. Yes, and then you have to find f dash of x. You know how to find the first order derivative. Yes, second step, put f dash of x is equal to 0, exactly equal to 0 you have to put. Why? To find the value or values of x in real numbers. Jo x ka values milega, that values must be real number. And how can we determine the values of x? After putting f dash of x equal to 0. If you don't know the values of x, then we cannot differentiate the increasing and decreasing interval part. Okay, so for this we should know the values of x, and x ka value find out karne ke liye f dash of x equal to 0 put karna hai. This is second step. Now the third step is divide the number line. You have to draw a number line. Divide the number line in which x lies, matlab x ka jo values milega wo sab values wo number line mein dalna hai. Theek hai, divide the number line in which x lies into disjoint subintervals with the help of the value or values of x obtained in step 2. मतलब second step से जो x का values मिलेगा वो ही x का values वो number line में डालना है. डालने के बाद कुछ subintervals मिलेगा वो मैं दिखा दूंगा example के साथ. Okay, the next step is in each subinterval, मतलब थर्ड स्टेप से जो इंटरवल्स मिलेगा सब इंटरवल्स, इन ईच सब इंटरवल चेक द नेचर ऑफ एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स. नेचर मींस वेदर एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो और एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स इज लेस देन जीरो. दिस इज कॉल्ड नेचर. ओके, थर्ड स्टेप से जो सब इंटरवल्स मिलेगा वो सब इंटरवल्स को चेक करना है f dash of x का नेचर क्या है, whether it is greater than 0 or f dash of x is less than 0. Now Roman 1, if f dash of x is greater than 0, मतलब कोई भी अगर एक sub interval में f dash of x का नेचर अगर greater than 0 मिला तो then we can say that the given function f of x is strictly increasing in that sub interval. Okay, but if f dash of x is less than 0, then we can say that the given function f of x is strictly decreasing in that particular subinterval. Okay, so these are the steps you have to follow to find the intervals in which the given function is increasing or decreasing. Important part hai increasing decreasing function ka. Okay, so now I'm going to give some examples. Exactly step wise main explain karunga. Theek hai, so have a look at the first example. First example is find the intervals in which the function f of x is equal to 4x cube minus 6x square minus 72x plus 30 is Roman 1 strictly increasing and Roman 2 strictly decreasing. Here no need to prove the function is increasing or decreasing. Here just you have to find the intervals. Okay, so जो मैं steps दिया था वही steps में follow करूंगा. Step 1 क्या बताया गया था? Write the given function. So here f of x is equal to 4x cube minus 6x square minus 72x plus 30. And then find f dash of x. So let us find f dash of x. That is 12x square minus 12x minus 72. Okay. Then put f dash of x is equal to 0. Yes, this is second step. If I put f dash of x equal to 0 from this function, easily we can take 12 common. So this will be x square minus x minus 6 is equal to 0. Why we need to put f dash of x equal to 0? To find the value or values of x. So यहाँ से जो quadratic equation है, ये quadratic equation से x का value मिलना चाहिए अभी. So x square minus 3x plus twice x minus 6. That means x minus 3 into x plus 2. That means we can say that the values of x are minus 2 and 3. This is the second step. थर्ड स्टेप क्या बताया गया था? जो x का वैल्यूज मिला सेकेंड स्टेप से, विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दीज वैल्यूज ड्रॉ ए नंबर लाइन एंड पुट दीज वैल्यूज टू गेट द सब इंटरवल्स. तो अभी मैं नंबर लाइन ड्रॉ करूंगा. दिस इज माइनस इंफिनिटी टू प्लस इंफिनिटी. पुट ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ x विच यू गेट इन द सेकेंड स्टेप. दैट मीन्स x का वैल्यूज क्या क्या मिला? माइनस टू एंड हेयर वी कैन राइट थ्री. दिस टू आर सो These two values of x divides this number line into how many disjoint sub intervals. अच्छा यहाँ पे मैं disjoint word use कर रहा हूँ. Why? Disjoint means जो join नहीं है. इसका मतलब होगा open interval. Okay? Disjoint means open interval होगा, not close interval. अगर close interval हो गया तो इसका मतलब होगा next इंटरवल के लिए वो पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट ऐड नहीं कर सकते हम लोग, इंक्लूड नहीं कर सकते. राइट, सो डिसजॉइंट मींस ओपन इंटरवल. सो दीज टू वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स डिवाइड्स दिस नंबर लाइन इनटू हाउ मेनी सब इंटरवल्स. फ्रॉम दिस नंबर लाइन ओनली यू कैन से दिस इज वन सब इंटरवल, सेकेंड वन, थर्ड वन. सो दैट मीन्स वी कैन से दैट the two values of x divides this number line into three disjoint sub intervals. ऐसे याद रख सकते हैं कि अगर x का दो वैल्यू मिला तो सब इंटरवल तीन होगा, x का अगर एक वैल्यू मिला तो सब इंटरवल दो होगा, मतलब एक ज्यादा सब इंटरवल मिलेगा. ओके, सो सिंस वी कैन से दैट नाउ द टू वैल्यूज ऑफ x डिवाइड्स दिस नंबर लाइन इनटू थ्री डिसजॉइंट सब इंटरवल्स, सो write those sub intervals. So therefore the sub intervals are open interval minus infinity comma minus 2, minus 2 comma 3 and 3 comma infinity. Okay, so these are the sub intervals. Disjoint word you have to use because all these, in these interval we are using open bracket. Right, what is the fourth step? In each sub interval, already I got three sub intervals. So in each sub interval, you have to check the nature of f dash of x. Nature means whether the f dash of x is greater than 0 or f dash of x is less than 0. For this, you can draw a table. This will be easy to identify the nature. Okay. Intervals f dash of x. What is f dash of x? F dash of x you got 12x square और बेटर यू कैन राइट एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू, जब जीरो पुट किया था वहां पे मिला था क्या, एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स एक्स माइनस थ्री इंटू एक्स प्लस टू, दिस विल बी बेटर. ओके एंड द नेचर, नेचर मीन्स वेदर इट इज इंक्रीजिंग और डिक्रीजिंग, हियर यू हैव टू राइट. सो द फर्स्ट सब इंटरवेल इज, द फर्स्ट सब इंटरवेल इज माइनस इंफिनिटी ओपन ब्रैकेट माइनस इंफिनिटी कॉमा माइनस टू. ओके देखो कैसे चेक करना है, सिंस द फर्स्ट सब इंटरवेल इज माइनस इंफिनिटी कॉमा माइनस टू, यू हैव टू एज्यूम एनी वैल्यू लाइज बिटवीन माइनस इंफिनिटी एंड माइनस टू. से एनी वैल्यू लाइज बिटवीन माइनस इंफिनिटी एंड माइनस टू, टेक स्मॉल वैल्यू, डोंट टेक बिग वैल्यू, ओके लार्ज वैल्यू. सो टेक स्मॉल वैल्यू लाइज बिटवीन माइनस इंफिनिटी एंड माइनस टू. वी कैन टेक माइनस फाइव, यस, because minus 5 lies between minus infinity and minus 2. So if we take minus 5 and if we put the value of x as minus 5, so minus 5 minus 3, minus 5 minus 3 will give, don't write the value, just you write the sign whether it is positive or negative. So minus minus, this will become plus. Okay, we all know minus 5 minus 3 means minus 8, lekin sign kya hoga, minus. Here if I put, here if I put minus 5, minus 5 plus 2 is negative value or positive value? It's negative value, so negative. So negative negative, multiplication sign hai na bich mein. So minus into minus is plus. So that means we can say that it is strictly increasing. That means in this interval, the function is strictly increasing. Because minus minus plus ho jayega. That means it is greater than 0. Okay? Which is greater than 0, यहाँ पे लिख सकते हो. Okay, then take the next sub interval, that is minus 2 comma 3. Say any value lies between minus 2 and 3, we can take 0. This is very easy, simple number. Okay, 0 लेने से यहाँ पे 0 minus 3 is negative value, 0 plus 2 is positive value. So minus into plus is minus, which is always less than 0. Therefore, we can say that in this sub interval, which interval, minus 2 comma 3, the function is strictly decreasing. Okay, then take the last sub interval, that is 3 comma infinity. Any value lies between 3 and infinity, say 5. So 5 minus 3 positive value, 5 plus 2 positive value, positive positive, it is greater than 0 only. So in this interval we can say that the function is strictly increasing. The function is strictly increasing. So ho gaya abhi. So therefore Roman 1 ka answer kya hoga, you have to find the intervals in which the function is strictly increasing. So in minus infinity and minus 2, you have to write like this, in minus infinity comma minus 2 and 3 comma infinity, the function is strictly increasing, whereas in minus 2 comma 3 the function is strictly decreasing. So this is the final solution. Okay, this is better. अगर ये table draw करने से nature आराम से पता चल जाता है. Don't write the values here. Again I am telling, don't write the values. जो भी value imagine करना है, assume करना है, वो value का sign क्या होगा यहाँ पे put करने से. जैसे कि मैं यहाँ पे minus 5 assume किया था. Minus 5 minus 3 is negative value. So negative sign. Minus 5 plus 2 is also negative value, so negative sign. Now negative into negative, positive, which is always greater than 0. So like this you have to write. Okay, so this is one example. Some more examples I will give now. So look at the next example. The question is same, just I have changed the function only. Here also you are asked to find the intervals in which the function f of x is equal to minus 2x cube minus 9x square minus 12x plus 1 is strictly increasing and strictly decreasing. So since the question is same only, so that means the procedure will be same. Find out f dash of x, this is equal to minus 6x square minus 18x minus 12, yes, and then put f dash of x is equal to 0. So if I put f dash of x is equal to 0, we can take minus 6 common and we can eliminate also. X square plus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. So x square plus 2x plus x plus 2 is equal to 0. That is, if I take x common x plus 2 plus 1 x plus 2, So therefore we can say that the possible values of x are minus 2 and minus 1. Then what you have to do? Draw a number line and put all these values of x on the number line. Minus infinity to plus infinity. First value is minus 2 and then minus 1, right? So these two values of x divides this number line into how many subintervals? X ka do value mila, iska matlab 3 subintervals aega. That means minus infinity to minus 2, minus 2 comma minus 1 and minus 1 comma plus infinity. Yes? So in what is the last step? In each subintervals you have to check the nature of f dash of x. So what is the first subinterval? Minus infinity comma minus 2. Ye subinterval mein f dash of x ka nature kya hai wo check karna hai. Achha, aur ek baat main batana chahta hu, yahan pe jo ye subinterval main bol raha hu, ye kya hai actually? Minus infinity to minus 2 jo mila, kahan se mila? Number line se mila. और ये नंबर लाइन में क्या पुट करने के बाद मिला? x का वैल्यूज पुट करने के बाद मिला. सो दैट मींस वी कैन से दैट दिस वन इज नथिंग बट x बिलोंग्स टू माइनस इनफिनिटी कॉमा माइनस टू. इसका मतलब है कि x लाइज बिटवीन, व्हेन x लाइज बिटवीन माइनस इनफिनिटी एंड माइनस टू. इसीलिए तो जो वैल्यू एज्यूम करना है, इसके बीच में जो वैल्यू एज्यूम करना है, वो वैल्यू x में ही तो पुट करना है. यस और नॉट? ओके. सो say any value lies between minus infinity and minus 2, again we can take minus 5. So if I take minus 5, then what will be the nature of f dash of x? Yahan pe main x step kam likha, better you write that step also. X plus 2 into x plus 1. So yahan se pata chal jayega. So if I put minus 5 plus 2 is negative value, minus 5 plus 1 is also negative value, negative into negative is positive. So that means we can say that in this subinterval, the nature of f dash of x is always greater than 0. So iska matlab ye sub interval mein function hamesha strictly increasing hi hoga. The next sub interval is minus 2 comma minus 1. Minus 2 comma minus 1. So in this sub interval, check the value. Minus 2 comma minus 1. Don't take 0 because 0 to minus 1 ke baad aega. So minus 2 or minus 1 ke beech mein kya le sakte hai? Minus 2 or minus 1 ke beech mein minus 1.5 le sakte hai. So if I take minus 1.5, this will be negative. Yes. This is positive because 2 is greater than minus 1.5. So dono mein kya hoga result? Minus 1.5, that means 2 minus 1.5 will give a positive value. Yes or not? And then again, here also if I put, then what will be the value? 2 minus 1.5, this is negative. Similarly, and x belongs to minus 1 comma infinity. Say any value lies between minus 1 and infinity. Minus 1 and infinity mein 5 le sakte hai. So 5 plus 2 positive value, 5 plus 1 positive value. So in this interval, in the third interval, f dash of x is always greater than 0. So iska matlab yahan pe strictly increasing hoga. Okay, I forgot to write here also. Ye second jo sub interval liya, isme kya hoga value? Whether it is greater than 0 or less than 0. Jo bhi value consider karna hai, माइनस टू और माइनस वन के बीच में वो वैल्यू अगर एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स में पुट करना है तो उसका नेचर क्या होगा? से एनी वैल्यू, मैं जो वैल्यू एज्यूम कर रहा हूं इसका मतलब वो नहीं कि वही वैल्यू लेना है. यू कैन टेक एनी वैल्यू. ओके, यू कैन टेक एनी वैल्यू. माइनस टू एंड माइनस वन, यू कैन टेक एनी वैल्यू. माइनस टू कॉम माइनस वन के माइनस 1.5 ले सकते हैं. सो हियर इट विल बी ऑलवेज लेस देन 0. सो इफ इट इज लेस देन 0, दैट मींस वी कैन से दैट हियर द फंक्शन इज स्ट्रिक्टली डिक्रीजिंग. ओके, सो दिस इज आल्सो अनदर एग्जांपल. सो ऐसा मॉडल का क्वेश्चन थोड़ा सा ठीक से सॉल्व करना है. सम मोर एग्जांपल्स आई विल गिव नाउ. नेक्स्ट वन इज the next question. Prove that f of x is equal to 4 sin x by 2 plus cos x minus x is increasing function, is an increasing function, is an increasing function of x in close bracket 0 comma pi by 2. Okay, this is one important question. Here you have to prove that the function is an increasing function of x in close interval 0 comma pi by 2. So yahan pe proof karna hai, intervals find out nahi karna hai, because already interval is given. Just you have to prove that in this interval the given function is always increasing. So since the function is a trigonometric function, yes or not? So since the function is a trigonometric function, that means we all know all trigonometric functions are continuous. देखो यहाँ पे जो प्रूफ करना है, प्रूफ करने के लिए उसका भी स्टेप्स में बताया था लास्ट क्लास में. यू हैव टू चेक द फंक्शन इज कंटिन्यूअस एंड डिफरेंशिएबल और नॉट. सिंस द फंक्शन इज अ ट्रिगोनोमेट्रिक फंक्शन, सो इट इज ऑलवेज कंटिन्यूअस एज वेल एज डिफरेंशिएबल इन द गिवन इंटरवेल. सो दैट मीन्स वी कैन गो फॉर फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव टेस्ट. सो एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स, फाइंड आउट एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स. यहाँ पे यू बाई वी रूल यूज करना है. यस, सो यू बाई वी रूल क्या था? u dash v, u dash करने से differentiation of 4 sin x is 4 cos x, u dash v minus v dash of u, that is 4 sin x whole into differentiation of 2 is 0, differentiation of cos x is minus sin x by v square. ठीक है, minus, don't forget to differentiate this particular x also, differentiation of x we all know 1, so therefore expand it. 8 cos x plus 4 cos square x plus 4 sin square x minus, if I take LCM, तो ये टर्म भी ऊपर आ जाएगा, तो 2 plus cos x whole square whole thing divided by 2 plus cos x whole square. Okay, so 8 cos x plus 4, because 4 cos square plus 4 sin square x, यहां से 4 common लेने से 1 हो जाएगा तो 4 ही रहेगा. ना इफ आई एक्सपांड दिस पार्ट, a प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर, 4 माइनस 4 कॉस एक्स प्लस, ओके दिस विल बी माइनस ऑल्सो, माइनस कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स. यस, सो प्लस 4 माइनस 4 विल बी कैंसिल डिवाइडेड बाय 2 प्लस कॉस एक्स होल स्क्वायर. सो 8 कॉस एक्स माइनस 4 कॉस एक्स इज 4 कॉस एक्स माइनस कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स डिवाइडेड बाय 2 प्लस कॉस एक्स होल स्क्वायर. यस, सो फ्रॉम हियर इफ आई टेक कॉस एक्स कॉमन, दिस विल बी 4 माइनस कॉस एक्स बाय 2 प्लस कॉस एक्स होल स्क्वायर. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स. नाउ यू हैव टू प्रूव दैट द गिवन फंक्शन इज एन इंक्रीजिंग फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स इन द क्लोज इंटरवेल 0, pi by 2. So close interval is given. So that means we can include 0 as well as pi by 2. इसका मतलब है कि 0, pi by 2 ये सब वैल्यू f dash of x में पुट करके चेक करना है कि whether the function f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0 or not. You have to prove greater than or equal to 0. Because for increasing, increasing का मतलब है greater than or equal to 0 आना चाहिए. So let us put 0. If I put 0 in this f dash of x, what's the value of cos 0? Cos 0 is 1. Yes. So here also if I put 0, cos 0 is 1. So numerator always positive. Whatever denominator, in the denominator also if I put 0, cos 0 again 1. So after putting 0 in this f dash of x, we can say that it is always greater than or equal to 0. अच्छा, equal to 0 होगा कि नहीं, कैसे चेक करना है? Pi by 2 भी तो पुट कर सकते हैं, not only 0. So if I put pi by 2, what's the value of cos 90 degree? We all know cos 90 is 0. Yes? So since cos 90 is 0, इसका मतलब numerator में पुट करने से पूरा 0 हो जाएगा, because 0 by anything is 0. So that means we can say that after putting 0, we are getting it is always greater than 0. After putting pi by 2, we are getting 0. So that means we can say that f dash of x is always greater than or equal to 0 when x belongs to close bracket 0 comma pi by 2. Since here close interval is given, you have to put both the end points. Yes, and you will get greater than or equal to 0 only, because you have to prove that it is an increasing function. Increasing बोला इसीलिए greater than equal to 0 होना चाहिए. अगर strictly increasing prove करना है तो only greater than 0 prove करना पड़ता है. ठीक है, यहाँ पे 0 भी satisfy कर रहा है ना, इसीलिए तो increasing prove करना है. ठीक है, so this is another model. Some more models I will discuss now. Have a look at the next question. It is also one important question. Find the least value of A. Least means the minimum value. Find the least value of A such that the function f of x is equal to x square plus ax plus 1 is strictly increasing. यहां पे बताया गया है कि ये function strictly increasing है on open interval 1, 2. Yes? You have to find the value of this unknown quantity A such that the given function is strictly increasing on open interval 1, 2. So, since you are asked to find the value of this unknown quantity, and here it is mentioned that the function is strictly increasing, so therefore you have to find the differentiation of the given function. So f dash of x is equal to twice x plus a. Yes or not? Why I am finding out this f dash of x? Bata raha hu iska bhi. Meaning, f dash of x is twice x plus a. Theek hai? Now, since here the interval is 1, 2, open interval 1, 2, then what does it mean? That is, here x lies between 1 and 2, because you have to find the minimum value of A such that f of x is strictly increasing on 1, 2, right? So f of x means what? Function of x. So iska matlab hai, ye jo function hai, which is in terms of x, this function is strictly increasing on open bracket 1, 2. Now this function is in terms of x or y or any other variable. This function is in terms of x. So that means we can say that here x lies between 1 and 2. Now why I have given strictly less than sign? Because here open bracket is there. That means excluding these two points. Okay. Now 1 less than x less than 2. Therefore we can, yaha pe jo f dash of x ka value mila, wo f dash of x ka value yaha pe aana chahiye. So what is the coefficient of x? In the last class also I have discussed this type of question. So, what's the coefficient of x here? X. Coefficient of x is 2. So, multiply 2. 2 less than twice x less than 4. Yes? So, f dash of x mein sirf twice x nahi hai. Twice x ke saath to a bhi hai. So, you have to add a on both sides. That means 2 plus a, which is less than twice x plus a, which is less than 4 plus a. That is 2 plus a, which is less than f dash of x, which is less than 4 plus a. To get f dash of x, you have to arrange this x like this only. ठीक है? क्योंकि अगर f dash of x ही f dash of x का अगर range नहीं मिलेगा तो a का value कैसे पता चलेगा? Because we can find the value of x, whether it is minimum value or maximum value, it doesn't matter. To find the value of A, you should know the range of f dash of x. Okay? मतलब f dash of x का range क्या होगा? कौन सा range में ये lie करता है? So that means clearly we can say that here f dash of x lies between twice 2 plus a and 4 plus a. Yes? Now, since f dash of x is strictly increasing, therefore f dash of x must be greater than 0. Yes or not? Agar strictly increasing hoga to strictly greater than 0. If it is strictly decreasing, then it is strictly less than 0. Okay, so f dash of x is strictly greater than 0. So which value you have to consider for greater than 0? Which value? अगर f dash of x less than 4 plus है, यहाँ पे तो clearly दिया गया है less than 4 plus है, so that means this value we cannot take. 2, since 2 plus a is less than f dash of x, देख लो यहाँ पे, since 2 plus a is less than f dash of x, so which implies we can say f dash of x must be greater than 2 plus a. अगर interchange करना है तो position, So that means we can say that 2 plus a is greater than 0, not this one. Because यहाँ पे clearly दिखाया गया है f dash of x is less than 4 plus a. ठीक है? So since 2 plus a is greater than 0, therefore we can say a is greater than minus 2. Yes or not? So greater than minus 2. Therefore the least value or the minimum value of a is minus 2. Okay, the minimum value of a is minus 2. So this is one important question. F of x दिया गया है. Question में बताया गया है कि it is an increase, strictly increasing function on open bracket 1, 2. Then what will be the minimum value of a? So to get the minimum value of a, you should know the value of f dash of x as well as the range of f dash of x. So range find out करने के लिए ये steps दिखाया गया है. Okay? Since the function is strictly increasing, so that means by the definition we can say f dash of x must be greater than 0. So f dash of x agar greater than 0 hai toh 4 plus a is not applicable. So 2 plus a is applicable. Yaha pe dikhaya hame. So 2 plus a is greater than 0 means a is greater than minus 2. So that means we can say that the least value or the minimum value of a is minus 2. Okay. So thank you for today.